too. Now, the season starts for the New Mexico Stars tomorrow at the Santa Ana Star Center.
Yeah, yesterday some of the players from the arena football team spent part of their day at Puesta del Sol Elementary speaking out against bullying. You know, that's so important.
It really is. You know, the thing is, I feel like athletes and entertainers are such role models, and no matter what, whether you want to pay attention or not, at the end of the day, they do have an impact on especially the youth.
And so kids look up to them.
They absolutely do. And so when they set a good example and they stand up for these kind of things, I feel like it really does, it changes the mindset of a lot of kids in a positive way. So we like to see that.
We really do love seeing that. Mm-hmm. Well, the warmer weather is moving ski season out. Sunday is your last chance to ski New Mexico. Taos and Santa Fe are closing this weekend, but there's still plenty of fun to be had before it does.
Oh, there always is, isn't there? Now, in Taos, don't miss pond skimming, okay? So if you have never gone pond skimming, take a look. That is when competitors use any means necessary to just literally skim across. I think it's like an 80-foot pool of ice-cold water. Can you imagine that? That's kind of scary. This annual, this is an annual end-of-the-season event. And you see her? That's got to be cold. It's taking place Sunday from 2:30 to 5 at the base of Strawberry Hill. The best costume earns extra points. Now, would you call that the best costume? I feel like that's not the best costume.
I think that girl had it pretty good just a little while ago. She went pretty far. She stayed up. She had it on. She was brave for what she was wearing, at least. She wasn't wearing very much. But yeah, a lot of fun there. And you know what? May 13th, I believe, Angel Fire opens back up again. Mm-hmm. It's season for mountain biking. Taos is going to have mountain biking this summer. So even though we're switching seasons, it's a lot of fun up in the mountains.
Well, I have to say that in Santa Fe, the Snow Bunnies can actually take advantage of some awesome savings in that sports shop because many items are now reduced to 50 to 60%. Awesome. And you know, when you go to those stores, that's sometimes where you spend a little more money. So this is a good way to get the discount. If you show your season pass, you get an additional 10% off too. So this is a great time to stock up for next year. Think ahead,
That's what I usually do. I usually try to buy, especially when it comes to that gear because it's so pricey. Mm-hmm. So it's always good to hit the deals when you can.
Oh, definitely. Now tomorrow, the public can tour the southern New Mexico site where scientists set off the world's first atomic bomb in 1945.
Yeah, the Trinity site is normally off limits to civilians. However, the military does allow visitors just 2 days a year, the first Saturday of April and October. The site is located at what is now White Sands Missile Range west of Alamogordo. Visitors can enter the range through the Stallion Range Center Gate. Google it if you're having trouble finding it. Mm-hmm. There's also a caravan leaving from the Tularosa High School football field parking lot at 8 a.m. Tours will operate from 8 to 2, and admission is free. So check it out when you can. I mean, 2 days a year, it's a really cool thing to see.
And it's free, so it's not even going to cost you anything. Well, okay, so I wore my dress in honor of the fact that I always like to match my shoes to my dress. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I have this color, but if you do, put them on. Your blue suede shoes are necessary. Head on over to a place you can't help falling in love with. Are you getting the jokes? Historic Old Town Albuquerque.
I got them.
Yes, get all shook up. Ooh. At the Elvis karaoke concert tonight from 5 to 8 on the plaza, you can dress like the king for the lookalike contest, wear 50 style apparel, or you can just come as you are. There's no requirements there. And before the night is over, the best Elvis karaoke performer will be crowned the king.
Of course.
Thank you very much. We have to say thank you very much, like at least 12 times.
You do. You should do it.
No.
Well, fun with Elvis continues tomorrow at 10 a.m. Brush up on your Elvis trivia at the gazebo, and a classic car show will celebrate the style of the era. Then later, the popular rockabilly trio, Cowboys and Indian, performs from 1 to 2:30, and don't miss Elvis's sandwich stand.
Isn't that fun?
Oh, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Now, if you go over there, we wanted to provide you with a few fun facts, okay? So here's a few goodies. Listen to this. Elvis came to Albuquerque back in April of 1956, and this was right before the hit song Heartbreak Hotel hit number one on the charts. So it wasn't even out there yet. It wasn't even a number one song yet. And then he played two shows at the Armory, and then he stayed at the Bodegar Mansion of Old Town Bed and Breakfast.
That's pretty cool.
Uh-huh.
Did not know that.
See?
Well, in 1956, this blows my mind, okay? It would have cost you about $1.50 to see Elvis perform in the Duke City. Can you imagine paying $1.50 to see one of your favorite performers these days? But admission for this weekend to see Elvis, the tribute weekend, is free. So make sure you check it out. 311, you can call that for more information.
Isn't that cool? I love that. That's a good story.
Well, an Albuquerque artist is getting national recognition for designing a rock star's tour poster. John Sanchez was recently notified that Fleetwood Mac chose his work to launch their 2013 summer tour. How awesome is that?
This is awesome. Sanchez was born and raised in Duke City, and he studied art and design at New Mexico State. Now, he's been designing posters. You can see all these different ones. This has been going on for him for different bands since 2008, and they're all drawn by hand using acrylic inks. And clearly, you know, he wanted to look ahead and do the right thing, so he didn't stop looking.
I love Fleetwood Mac.
I really wanted to do it. Don't stop thinking about tomorrow joke, but it didn't really work. Okay, so by the way, we have some good news for you. John is going to be a guest on New Mexico Style Tuesday of next week, so you really want to stay tuned. I'm so curious to hear what he has to say and what this made him feel like to know that a legendary band is using his poster.
That has got to be a great feeling.
Right?
It's got to be up there, I'd say.
So exciting about that. Okay, now we have some more information for you also about Funny Man Seth MacFarlane's new film, the one that's rolling into the land of enchantment. Mm-hmm. We first told you about this Western comedy, A Million Ways to Die in the West, earlier this week, and now we know that it will be shot around the Jemez Pueblo, Shiprock, Bonanza Creek, and Chama from May through July.
Right, and great time of the year to shoot it up there.
Oh, yeah.
It feels really nice. Well, so, you know, the movie's about a cowardly sheep farmer who backs out of a gunfight but then finds his courage with the help of a mysterious woman. Seth will co-star with Charlize Theron, Amanda Seyfried, and also Sarah Silverman, and maybe you. The production plans to hire 1,200 local crew members and more than 2,000 extras. So
I'd want to do that just to meet Charlize Theron. I just love her.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, I do, too. She is... I don't know how she stays so beautiful.
She is like a movie star.
She really is. She's from Africa, right?
Yes, she's South Africa,